Hi to every one of you here. So welcome to a new session with Score With Me, and today we are going to see a very small trick in simplification which generally comes in SSC exams. This is IP here to assist you in cracking competitive exams. So today we have come with a very short and simple trick, simplification trick on questions which normally apply in SSC CGL exams. Okay, so here we have taken a question. 5 times the digit 5 when added to 4 times digit 5 to 555, 55 and 5. We need to find the sum. So normally what do? We take all the 1's digit, add them. We take the 10's digit, add them. 100's place and add them, isn't it? So now we are not going to do that. What are we going to do is, we are just going to count how many numbers of 5 we have got. So how many numbers of 5 have we got? So here we have got 5 number of 5's. Here we have got 4 numbers. Here we have got 3 number of 5's. Here 2 number of 5 and here just 1 5. So we have numbered how many number of digits do we have. And now what are we going to do? We are going to multiply the number of digits with the common digit. So the common digit here is 5. So here 5 into 5. So our first digit in the sum place is going to be 5 and a carry 2, 25. Next we are going to multiply this common digit 5 with 4, number of 5's. So 5 into 4 will give you 20. Here we already have a carry, so we get 22. Here we have 3 number of 5's and 3 into 5 will give you 15, already a 2, so 7, carry 1. 2 into 5 will give you 10. You have a 1 carry, so that becomes 11. 5 into 1 is 5. You have a carry 1. So the answer for this question is 61725. Let me repeat once again. How are we going to do? We are going to first find how many digits we have with common number being 5. So here 5 number of 5's, 4 number of 5's, 3 number of 5's, 2 number of 5's and last 1 number of 5. Here we are going to multiply the number of digits into the common number, that is 5. So 5 into 5 will give you 25. Write that in the rightmost place. 2 gets carried over. I'll write the product here once again. So the first number is 25. Next, 4 into 5 will give you 20. The carry 2, so it becomes 22. 3 into 5, 15. The carry 2, so the number becomes 17. 5 2 is a 10, carry 1, it becomes 11, 5 into 5 is 1 and the number is 61725. This is the answer. For better understanding of the same trick, we are going to do one more sum here. 4 times 6, 3 times 6, 2 times and 1. So we are not wasting time, directly going. Count the number of 6, there are 4 number of 6, there are 3 number of 6, there are 2 number of 6, there are 1 number of 6. Now we are multiplying 4 with the common number 6. So 4 into 6, you get 24, carry 2. 3 6 are 18, carry 2. 18 plus 2 is 20. 2 over here. 6 into 2, 12, carry 2. So it becomes 14. 6 1s are 6, carry 1, 7. So see how easy is this? These are the practice questions for this session. For solving question 3 and 4, watch the video till the end. Happy solving! Now here, a small deviation from the previous question. There are numbers where whole numbers. Here we have taken if the numbers are decimals. So what is the difference? Same method, there is no difference, only the direction in which we take multiplication products. So here, again, as we did in the previous question, we are going to count the number of 4's. How many 4's do we have here? Just 4 number of 4's. Here we have 3 number of 4's. Here we have 2 number and here we have 1 number of 4. So that step is same. That has not got changed. Now, where is the change? When we had whole numbers, what did we do? We multiplied this 4 with the common digit being 4. 4 4s are 16 we did and we started writing from the right, isn't it? Now here, the small change is that the same thing we are multiplying, but here we are doing from the right hand side first. So without decimal, when there was no decimal, without the decimal, we started our multiplication and writing the numbers from the right hand side. Here when a decimal is coming, we are starting our calculation from here. So when the numbers are with decimal, have this thing alone in mind that here our product starts from the right end. Okay, and we are taking 4 into 1 is 4. We have got no carry. 4 into 2. 4 into 2 is 8. We still don't have carry. Next, 4 into 3 is 12. No carry. Sorry, 4 into 3 is 12. 1 carry over here. Next, 4 into 4 times 4. 4 fours are 16. We had a carry over here, so that becomes 17. Since there is no more number, we need to write that here. So this is our answer, but remember we have had got decimals. So what are we going to do? We need to see the highest number of decimals. We have got 4 decimal places. So starting from the right, 1, 2, 3, 4. Answer is 1.7284. Remember, process is same. Process did not change, but where did we have a change? The direction in which we started writing our number. So without the decimal, when we had like 4 times 4 plus 3 times 4 plus 2 times 4 and a 4. When we had a question like this, what did we do? We counted 4. So here we started our product from. When this was our case, we started writing our product from this sign. So 4 4s are 16. 4 3s are 12, carry 1, 13. 4 2s are 8, carry 1, 9. 4 1s are 4. This was our sum. So we started doing from this end because we did not have decimal, without decimal. When we had decimal, we started doing it from the right end. So that is where the change comes. Okay. The same practice question is shown once again. Take a screenshot and in the comment section, please come up with the answers. Thank you. Keep practicing. Keep solving more and more papers. Do as many questions as you can. And as far as simplification tricks are concerned, only with practice you can overcome any simplification. So keep practicing more and more papers, keep solving more and more sums, and apply these tricks when these come into questions. So until we see in the next video, take care and do like, subscribe to the channel if you like this video. Thank you so much. Bye.